Hey, what's up, guys? Today we are going to be doing a fun audio comparison test of the new Joby Wavo Pro and seeing how it compares and sounds versus the Sony and Rode and all that fun stuff. So let's shoot some fun audio side-by-side comparisons. So we've got the mic set up here, cool little Joby setup. We're gonna do some side-by-sides, go around the city, see how they sound and compare. All right, this is audio at a water fountain. It's pretty loud behind me. This is with active noise reduction off, and now this is with active noise reduction turned on. Can you hear any sound difference? Now this is audio on the Rode VideoMic NTG. This is one of the most popular YouTuber, vlogger mics. It's really good quality. How does it sound versus that Joby? And now this is the Sony ECM yada yada. It's not the greatest name, but honestly, one of my favorite mics, as I'll show you later, it doesn't need any external cords or battery. It's all powered through the hot shoe connector in my A7S III. So here's audio on that Sony. How does it sound and compare to the others here in front of the water fountain? Now let's do a little scooting and background wind test. This is audio on the Joby Pro. How does it sound? And now this is audio on the Rode. We're scooting along and it's pretty windy down here. So how does it sound? You guys gotta let me know your favorites down in the comments. And now this is audio on the Sony Hot Shoe Shotgun mic. It's honestly one of my favorites, but I'm really intrigued with these results. How are they all gonna sound and compare with that background wind and scooting sound? I'm always filming these sort of shots for my YouTube videos. Now, Emory, I'm feeling a little thirsty. You wanna head downtown to Huntsville and grab maybe a coffee?
Hell yeah, if Authentic's buying.
Guys, I love Joby tripods. If you guys are looking to find out which is the best for your setup, check out my video on that whole comparison after this one. It's a real Casey Neistat setup right here. Now, it was a fun little baseline. This is audio on the iPhone 13 Pro. Video audio on these things just really isn't the best. So here's how it sounds with some background traffic noise. Now this is audio with the Joby with active noise reduction turned on. How's it doing with removing some of that traffic noise? Now this is audio with the Rode NTG video, whatever. How's it sound with that loud traffic sound behind me? And this is audio on the Sony Shotgun mic at the traffic intersection. How does it sound and how does it compare? All right, so we're in the coffee shop. It's kind of that quintessential spot where you'd want that active noise reduction. So this is with it turned off on the Joby. Now let's go ahead and turn it on. And this is with it turned on. Can you hear any difference? All right, and now this is audio on the Rode NTG here in the coffee shop with some background noise. How does it sound? How does it compare? And last up, this is audio on the Sony Shotgun. These are the exact tests that I would run myself when I'm trying to figure out which is the best run and gun shotgun mic for my content creation. So this is audio on the Sony Hot Shoe microphone. It actually has a few filters. This is with filters off and there's a bit of background wind. How does it sound? Now this is with LC or low cut turned on. This is supposed to remove some of that wind noise, vibrations, air conditioners, that sort of thing. And this is NC or noise cut. They say it's for unpleasant noises and stuff like that. So can you hear a difference between all three? On the side of the Joby mic, there's actually a gain boost. So this is with it set at zero. Now this is plus 10. Did you hear those levels come up a bit? And this is plus 20. Is it super loud and crisp or is it maybe a little bit too much? Are we bringing up some of that background noise that we don't want? Two quick updates. I got a firmware update just the other day. It took like half an hour, a super long, but I wanted to give a quick update to the ANR, active noise reduction. This is with it turned off here at the lake. And this is with it turned on. Can you hear any difference? Now, point number two is the clarification. I always thought that was gonna help remove some of that background wind noise and stuff like that, but I actually think, per their website, it's just gonna remove some of the bumps and wobbles and shakes from camera movement and stuff like that. So I guess there you go. All right, so I'm kind of doing a little bit drastic wobbles and stuff. This is ANR off, and then let's go ahead and turn it on. Can you hear any difference in those wobbles, shakes, bumps? Is it actually doing anything? So this setup is kind of cool. I've got the Pro shotgun mic on top of the A7S here. Let me show you guys. And then using the Joby extension arms, and that external wireless mic setup, I've got a clipped on lapel. It should be left channel, right channel, so I can go out far distance and you should still be able to hear me just fine. And then we also have that shotgun mic that we can use for ambient sounds and action things like that here on the microphone. So I think my favorite top pick, what do you guys think? I'm gonna go with the Sony, and here's why. I love that it connects. No cords or cables needed directly into the hot shoe into my Sony A7S. No internal rechargeable battery that I have to remember to charge up. The audio level seem to be recorded super loud, and maybe part of that is because through this hot shoe connection into the Sony, it automatically sets the levels. Now you can go manual if you want, but auto seemed to raise everything up super loud. It brought in some of that background noise, but it was forgivable in my opinion at least. I love the physical buttons and switches right on the back here. It's quick and efficient to quick toggle through. And even though that Joby, which you're hearing right now, and the Rode still has some of its unique features over this one, I think I'm gonna be grabbing this one for most of my run and gun shooting needs. As with all of these microphones, links down below. If you guys wanna check out our next video on these Joby wireless lavs and how they compare versus the Rodes and stuff like that, I'll see you guys over in that video, and thanks for watching.